should I feel discouraged? Why should the shadows fall? Why should my heart heaven and home? Thank you, Lord, when I've got Jesus, Jesus for my portion, and I call. can you be lonely?
Thank you. thank you for your goodness towards us. We thank you for your saving grace. We thank you that you have spared our life to be in your presence once more. Father, we thank you for traveling mercy. Thank you that you took us all here safely. Father, and as we proceed through this funeral service, we crave your leading, we crave your guidance. Father, we pray that all will be done to the honor and glory of your name. And as we cease to put away the remain of our beloved sister, Father, we pray that you will be with us, and we pray that you will take full control of the service. We ask all these mercies, giving you thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
At this time, we'll have our first scripture lesson, and I'll ask that when you come, you turn on the mic. There's a Bible on the podium, and you can use that one. From Psalm 90, 1 to 12, Shauna Shields, granddaughter, and Caria Leah, will granddaughter, will come and do the first lesson for us. Taken from Psalm 90, 1 to 12.
Lord,
heal
them. Lord, you have been dwelling in our place throughout all generations. Before the mountains were born, for you brought forth the whole world from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn people back to them, say, return to us, Lord. A thousand years in your sight are like a day that has just gone by, or like a watch in the night. Yet you sweep people away in the sleep of death. They are like the new grass of the morning. In the morning it springs up new, but by evening it is dry and withered. We are consumed by your anger and terrified by your indignation. You have set our iniquity before you, our secret sin in the light of your presence. All our days pass away under your wrath. We finish our years with a bow. Our days may come to 70 years or 80 if our strength endures. Yet the best of them are but troubles and sorrows, for they quickly pass and we fly away. If only we knew of the power of your anger, your wrath is as great as the fear that is your due. Teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Here ends the reading of God.
Thank you very much. At this time, we'll have a solo by Luke Williams, cousin-in-law.
I went to the house where she used to live. The grass has grown up, it covers the door. Someone across the street said, "No, who you see?" But she don't live there anymore.
Somewhere around the throne of God. Somewhere
Absent from the body is to be present somewhere around God's throne. Thank you, sir. At this time, we'll have the second lesson taken from 2 Thessalonians chapter 4, 13 to 18 by the Andrew Bright. Grandma.
Even as the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even then also that are fallen asleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we are alive, that we are left unto the coming of the Lord, shall in no wise precede them that have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from the heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then those that are alive, that are left, shall together with them be caught up in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. The end of reading of God's word.
Wayne Gray, cousin, Morris Retirement Home, Remembrance by Mr. Hulnach, CDJT, and you'll come in that call.
Good afternoon. I know it's a sad occasion, but we're here to celebrate a life that was well lived, a life that can be seen as an example for us to follow, and a life that is worth emulating. Mothers are more than just special. Their love knows no bounds, and the assurance of it is more than tongue can tell. Ask the men present here today. Who is the most important parent? And I'm sure we'll all say mom. Ask the mothers, and they will smile and continue to care and to nurture and to love, just as only they know how to. You see, mothers have been asked to double up from ever since. When Papa run off, mother has to double up as mother and father and to bring up the child in the best way she knows. When mama runs out, then all papa does is take the child to grandma. So grandma has to double up and to do it all over again. Looking back at my childhood days, I must say that I got all my beatings from mama and grandma's. But there was something special about these beatings, and it took me a while to figure it out. What I came up with is those beatings, they were medicinal, in that they were just on time, after right amount, wasn't pleasant to the taste, but it cured all the ailments. And today I can say, like CVM, just look at me now. Looking in, looking out, looking even better. Thanks to Mother. Some of us offer an attribute. We'll say, thank you, Mama, for the 9 months you carried me, all those pains and suffering. Others will say, I remember Mama and the love that she gave. But I am going to say, Mama, you gave life to me, turned a baby into a grown man. And Mama, all you had to offer was a promise of a lifetime of love. Now I know there is no other love like a mother's love for her child. And I know a love so complete someday must leave, must say goodbye. Goodbye's the saddest word I care for me. Goodbye's the last time I will hold your name. Someday you'll say that word and I will cry. It'll break my heart to hear you say goodbye. Mama, turn the young one into a strong man. And Mama, all I ever needed was a guarantee of you loving me. 'Cause I know no.
had no choice but to rush down to the home. And when I saw Erna, I touched her. I played with her, as I always do, believing that she was going to say, "Oh, Nurse Joan, stop pinching her, stop doing something." But that was impossible. She was dead. And this goes to show, no man knows the minute nor the hour when we're going to leave this world. So we must be ready. We must stay ready. And I do believe that Miss Erna was ready. The Murray's retirement home family want to tell Erna's family, thanks for lending her to us. We will miss her dearly. We love her, but Jesus loved her best. Sleep on, Erna. Sleep on and take your rest.
Members of the clergy, and I'm so delighted to see the Reverend. We're all used to our own ministers here, but I'm so delighted to see the Reverend Stachel Lambert of Zorn, which is Pro's church up in Christiana. And I'd like, on behalf of the family, to recognize the presence of some dignitaries among us. I heard that Mr. Michael Stewart is here. Mr. Stewart, are you here? Mr. Stewart, over here. Mr. Michael Stewart, our Member of Parliament for South Manchester, and Opposition Deputy Spokesman on Education, our own Mr. Michael Phillips, our Member of Parliament for North Western Manchester, and Opposition Spokesman on Transportation. And then I hear that my old friend, who I haven't seen for such a long time, Mr. Pacey, our Deputy Mayor, is here somewhere. Mr. Pacey, are you here? Mr. Phillips assured me that you are here. Mr. Phillips, he has disappeared. Maybe he's outside. That's Mr. Aaron Facy. He's our Deputy Mayor and Deputy Chair of the Manchester, formerly Manchester Parish Council. But since last year, we have to learn the new name now. It's now Manchester Municipal Corporation. Am I right on that? And in mentioning the corporation, which was in fact Erna's employee for so many, many years, and I understand the council, me making the mistake of saying council again, in fact it's a corporation now. I understand there are representatives here of the Manchester Municipal Corporation. If you are here, could you kind of stand to be recognized, please? Manchester Municipal Corporation representatives. Church is a bit too small, we have been like. They are somewhere outside. And our ever faithful counselor, our ever faithful counselor, whose first name is Faith. Mrs. Faith Sampson, could you stand to be recognized, Faith? So nice seeing you. And other dignitaries. And then I have to especially refer to RAD, meaning Rural Agricultural Development Authority. Did I get that correct? RAD, and our parish manager from Manchester, Ferrara. Are you here, sir? Could RAD as representative please stand from wherever you are in Jamaica? RAD, Manchester and the rest of Jamaica, thank you ever so much for the support you are giving to Erna's daughter. Erna herself served for a very long time in what was then Manchester Parish Council, or the Manchester Municipal Corporation. And to see her daughter following in her footsteps of community and national service. She has served so long at Rado, that's who I'm referring to, ever, let alone up in Christiana, now here she's still flowing. She has served so long that when she told me how long it is, I thought it was her whole age. And that she's pretty near to retirement, can you believe it? Of course, I don't think you all know the meaning of the word retirement. We can only be classified, and we better let the MP understand. So I understand you can only be classified as retired if you get a pension. If you have no pension, the Lord help you. In asking you to join me in remembering Erna Young, better known as Erna Young, but she took on a color afterwards and became Young Brown, but still accepted by us as Erna Young. She and the rest of us, including myself, we were pre-independence people, you know, before 1962. And she was born just on a hillside, not too far down from here. And interestingly, maybe some 40 or so years before she was born, this church was born. Also down in a valley not far from here. You begin to see the connection. Then, this being the first church to come to Manchester, to come to Coley Mountain, it put the building behind us there up as both church and school. So it was school Monday to Friday, but Friday was not Monday. Most of the kids are gone and going to heaven, you know. So it was more Monday to Thursday. But that's where Erna went to school, right over there, and to church and Sunday school right here. Now we were very, very fortunate in those days to have had excellent teachers. Mr. Stewart, if you're hearing me, that is not to suggest that teachers of your educational days, before you take on the legislative days, were not as good. But being as good means you literally benefited from the earlier bunch. And also, we had excellent church workers, and nobody from this area can forget and Miss Isabel Foster. The lady was so dignified, the lady was such an example for girls, and including Erna and all the others went out from here. Qualified, trained, speak about etiquette, speak about how you speak, how you relate. So we were not surprised to see that in fact Erna went out, did herself well in two fields, in local government where she worked in the works, road and works department, and afterwards in the area of nursing. And thank you so much, nursing home, for having taken such good care of her in her final days. We recognize Easter and the fact that we are right in the Easter season. Aren't we? Have I been speaking all along without a microphone? Maybe that's why I'm not communicating at all. Just me. Testing.
Testing?
Wow! So are you saying that all I've said before is just lost?
No!
Builders of these early churches understood the subject we call acoustics and the reproduction of sound in buildings like this. Excellent. I was just making a point about Easter. We are here paying our final respects to Erna, who has come back to her community at this Easter time. And I must give you one on Easter. There was this retired master teacher who was helping her grandson with homework or what have you, and she was a committed Christian lady, and she wanted to understand the story of Jesus and the story of Easter very well. And she used all her teaching methodologies and all her dramatic skills to tell her what a good man Jesus was. And all these cruel people beat him up. They did all sorts of manner of things to him. And eventually they murdered him. And the little boy was so surprised. He jumped around and said, "Grandma, Grandma, Jesus never had a gun." That's Easter out there. But here at Easter, we always remember, not so much more than Jesus, you know, but a little, soft, gentle lily called the Easter Lily. You remember the Easter Lily?
Yes.
It disappears for a long time, and then it reappears as a beautiful plant called in the little flower gardens that decorated all the homes around. And if not in the flower garden, down in our cottages. Right, Easter Lily? And interestingly, I'm told by the family that Erna's daddy, Mr. Ivan Young, passed away on Good Friday some long time ago. And to see that they are here, pay your final respects to his daughter in the same Easter season. May I, with you, ladies and gentlemen, say how much we admire the family, all that they have done in this community, the service that she has rendered to the parish of Manchester, and the example she has set for her children, that they have gone out there and are rendering services as best they can. We remember with love and affection Erna Young.
Thank you very much for those tributes and remembrance, and you can always depend on Mr. Nash to do the honors and make certain that all those who are to be recognized be recognized. Thank you very much, Mr. Nash. At this time, we'll have some words of comfort by Shauna Shields and Deandra Bryce, granddaughters. Words of comfort.
For you will be truly missed and remembered for love and honor in which we will preserve. We love you always and forever, Mama. May your soul rest in peace and light perpetual shine upon you. And tribute for Mama. I grew up with a grandma who cared. Adoration, devotion, and love we shared. My grandma unselfishly nurtured as she tenderly spoke of my future. In my heart, I had a crippling fear that one day my mama would not be there. That fear came true. It's life changing. My deepest sorrow, I couldn't contain. A wholesome feeling washed over me. My mama, an angel, was soon to be, would leave me with my heart broken, without a robe to visit in heaven. Blowing it with kisses said, that's what I can do. Every time I want to say, Mama, I love you. So caring, so giving, so kind. Loving memories come to mind. Although Mama, you are gone, I know I will never be alone. Blowing kisses to heaven, that's what I can do. Because of the love you've given, Mama, I'll always send love to you.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Ted. My mom first saw me.
My mom first told me. When I surpassed the poor for all these years, and Jimmy James, they motivated me. And I have. How could I have a mom when I had a way to come and talk the goodness of her? One thing she deep in my heart, she used to cook rice and peas, wicky wicky, and a song. Only time. This beat where she beat me, minimum was it was a medication beat. It motivated me and quote, that's where you could have come back. Mama, we love you. You need to know what went inside of me. We know that she have 5 kids. 1 boy and 1 girl. So the sister who will love. I rather dead if my sister's dead, we can't go through no more life. I'm gonna know her. But she worked hard to raise 5 kids though, as a single mother. And I never know what it is like to be a single mother until they get old. It's not easy. You may see me a laugh, but you don't know what's going inside. Miss Erna, I'm not telling you to grab business. And they great drum. Any wish you did. Miss Erna, I'm gonna love you. I never get the chance to tell you. So I'm sorry I won't. Come and run with. Take care.
Yeah.
time we'll have a selection from Rod.
Well, this song that I'm about to sing right now, reaching out to all the family members who have lost their loved one, just want to tell them Jesus Christ, He cares. God's promise to take care of all His children, yeah, when they're going through some rough times in their lives. Oh, when it seems that all around has fallen, yeah, and the devil tells you you can always say, only believe with your faith and your trust in the Lord, you will deliver right on time. Set before the day's over, before the night's through,
a few minutes
from the Word of God. I ask you to open your Bibles if you have one. Ecclesiastes chapter 8. And verse 8. There is no man that has power over the spirit to retain it, neither have you power in the day of death. There is no discharge in that war. Neither wickedness, there are those that are given to it. There is no discharge. There is no discharge. Let us look to the Lord in a brief word. Our Father, it pleases you to obtain the system. There is death, there is bereavement, there is heartache, there is sorrow. We ask Heavenly Father that you wrap your loving arms around you. Family in particular. Sustain them by your grace. Build them up in the most holy faith. Help them, Lord, to reach out to you. Allow your holy comfort to give them the comfort that they so desire at this time. Take your precious word and apply it to the lives of each one. Let the words of my mouth and meditations of my heart be accepted in your sight, O Lord, your strength and our Redeemer. Amen. The theme I'd like to speak to you on: death, the greatest reaper. Death, the greatest reaper. Death is always reaping what he has not sown. Death is always fearful and frightening. We can never get accustomed to it. There is no respecter of person. Therefore, it is important for all of us to set our hopes in our mind. What I'm trying to say here is to put things in perspective. Maybe you want to write your will. But make sure that you know God. We do not know when He's going to call on us.
perfected. And resistance vain, said the wise man, according to the song. History records the only two men who escaped death, Elijah and Enoch, according to the writings of the kings. Death is not only fearful and frightening, but it is carefully transmitted. And careful in its attack on the human race. And you're experiencing that this evening. Geographically, the earth is his domain. Therefore, it is safe to conclude that death is universal. The scripture concludes, all men must die. All men must die. There are those who have gone on before, and others follow after. We are going to go one day. Erna is gone. We are going to go one day. Saved or unsaved, good or bad, rich or poor, educated or uneducated. And you can add to that. As God is no respecter of person, so is death. The philosophy of some death is the end. And so to settle a problem, they can take their own lives and that of others. And I don't have to tell you that this is the norm of the day. This is the norm. But I have news. I have news. It is not over. It is not over. The scripture is the only final authority on the subject of death and immortality. It is given by inspiration of God. It is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction in our righteousness. That's the scripture. Death will not vanish or expel one from standing before God. Will one day have to stand before his creator God at his judgment bar. Death, of course, can be seen as an appointment for all. It has been appointed. Maybe you have cancel appointment to be here. But look here. Here is one you cannot cancel. Death. Death, whether you like it or not. We can't postpone it. You think you can postpone death? We can't postpone it. It is God's appointment for mankind. This is God, do this. All men must die or undergo a change equivalent to death. And after this death, judgment. Judgment. Some people decide the type of funeral they want and the type of casket they want. And some people have, some family member of course, have some sort of problem because somebody like this one and others don't like it. So here's the problem. But look here, let me tell you something. Quarry as you may, choose as you may, in spite of the color, whether it be gold or silver, look here. Look here. Having little or no concern for soul, concern for what type of casket. But they don't think about this world. Brother and sister, we need to think about our soul. We have one, not two. Job says, men will be brought to death and the host appointed for him. There's a host that is appointed for him. Death is destined. The wise, the foolish, the brutish must die one day. The righteous death are precious in the sight of the Lord. The righteous death are hopeful. There is hope. That's why the lyrics is, there is hope in King Jesus. There is hope in God. The righteous death is great gain. Paul speaking to the Philippians said, for me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. They die with decency, dignity, and honor. Heaven is made richer for the righteous day. John says, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Observe here, description of those who are called blessed. Those who die in the Lord. They die in the cause of Christ. They are found in Christ when death comes. The demonstration of the blessing. They are blessed in their rest. If a sister know the Lord, then she is blessed in her rest. The rest from sin, sorrow, and persecution. They are happy in time of dying. They have Simeon's desire. for mine eyes have seen thy salvation. O Lord, let now thy sister depart in peace, and light perpetual shine in her. God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Death is not the end for the Christians. But I'm hoping and trusting that those who are not saved, that you realize that there's coming a time when you will have to give an account for yourself. And only what is done for Christ will last. At this time, we'll continue with our tributes. Councillor Faith Thompson and Mrs. Charlotte Grant, family friend, in that order.
Ministers Polk and Lambert, Elder James, members of Parliament, Michael Phillips and Michael Stewart, Mr. Nash, CDJP, Deputy Mayor Facy, members of the bereaved family, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. On behalf of my family, the Johns Hall Division, and the entire Northwest Manchester, I extend condolences to the bereaved family. Yvette and Ted, and other members of the family, you're going through one of the most difficult periods of your life. But God is able to, and He will take you through this difficult period. Some words and phrases rush to mind when we reflect on and give thanks for the life of Ernol Young Brown, as I knew her, Miss Erna. Eloquent speaker, hardworking, kind, mother extraordinaire, fearless, elegant, ambitious, beautiful, and the list goes on. Miss Erna was hardworking. The job was never too difficult. As long as it could take care of her and her children, it was her job. An eloquent speaker she was. She would deliver great speeches. Her public speaking and presentation skills were matchless. She was fearless and would take on any situation, even if others think it was difficult or even sometimes dangerous. If she believed it could be done, then it would be done. Miss Erna was beautiful. She was a head turner. One had to take another look. She had to look at her a second time. I am sure if she lived her younger life now, she would have been signed up with Paul's or one of the other modeling agencies. And I'm sure one of her grandchildren, probably beautiful Kiara, might think about taking it on. Not only was she beautiful, but she was always elegantly attired. She had a stately look, and at all times, her height complemented this. She stood out in any crowd. As long as she was around, you would not miss her. And she did not have to flaunt her beauty. She shined naturally. To say she was kind is almost an understatement. Her generosity knew no end. If she had it and you needed it, it was yours. Even if she was left with little, she would still find enough to give. Miss Erna was ambitious. The sky was the limit for her. Mediocrity in any form was not in her book. She was a strong woman, a very, very strong woman. She had an inner strength not many of us possess. I watched her over the years as she buried three of her children. I wondered how on earth she did it. Persons have not gotten over the death of one child, but Miss Erna went through it three times, and she kept her spirits up, always giving thanks to God for keeping her through. A real phenomenal woman. She was mother and grandmother extraordinaire. Her children and grandchildren meant the world to her. They were her heartbeat. Yvette, Sister Flo, Ted, grandchildren, siblings and other relatives, you must feel proud this afternoon, regardless of feeling of sadness, of the legacy and the testimony she has left behind. Miss Erna was one of the cornerstones of Coley Mountain. And you can walk, get a flag, put your face on it, and wave it high, which says, I am an offspring of Erna Young. All you need to do now is to emulate her great qualities. And as you grieve, do so knowing that this is not goodbye, because she's just gone on before us. Sleep good, Miss Erna. Meet you on the other side of Jordan. Her soul will rest in peace, and light perpetual shine on her.
Good afternoon, everyone. Tribute for the late Miss Erna Young Rose. Miss Erna left was a blessing to others, but now she is gone. She endured much while living, and she carried on. Miss Erna will be misbanded as the days go by, but we must never question why. God saw it fit for him to let Miss Erna go and let her rest in peace until he comes again. Her hearing will be keen. She will have perfect vision in the earth and heaven. We will miss Miss Erna and her happy face. Father, give us courage. Remember, Miss Erna, love you all. Rest in peace, Miss Erna.
At this time, we'll have the eulogy by Mrs. Sharon McLean Williams. Don't
cry for me, it's over. Smile because it happened. In the end, it's not the years in which your life that count, it's the life in your ears. We are here today to remember the life of Ernol Luretta Young Brown, Miss Erna, Nurse Brown, and celebrate what she meant to us all. For those of you whom I haven't yet had the pleasure of meeting, I am Sharon McLean Williams, David McLean's daughter, dearest cousin of Miss Erna. I would like to thank all for coming here today to mourn the loss of Cousin Erna, with special thanks to those who traveled from the USA, England, Canada, and Cayman Island. Miss Erna was born on June 26, 1938, in the district of Coley Mountain. Her parents, Erna Young and Ivan Young, were housewife and fishermen, respectively. Her mom died when she was just 3 months old, so she was especially close to her grandmother, Etta McLean, Nana. As they lived together until she predeceased her on February 10, 1972. She attended the Coley Mountain Elementary School. After leaving school, she practiced cosmetology within the community, after which she transitioned into her career at the Manchester Parish Council, occupying the capacity of a county clerk. After 16 years of service to the Manchester Parish Council, she then entered the field of practical nursing. She interned at the University of the West Indies Hospital for 6 months, then formally practiced in retirement homes. Miss Erna was happily married to Philip Brown for 4 years, who predeceased her as well. My favorite moment of Cousin Erna is that she was ambitious, fearless, elegant, and beautiful. She has the kindest heart. She was a hard and tireless worker. She was a passionate and colorful woman. Love of life, no nonsense, octogenarian. She had five children, Courtney, Ben, Yvette, Flo, Chester, Perry, Andrew, Bobby, and her dog. Three precedes her. After the death of her last son, her dog, she was diagnosed with chronic diabetes, leading to total blindness. She then became a resident of the Murray's Retirement Home, Cornwall Road, Mandeville, Jamaica, for 1 year. On March 14, 2017, she peacefully transitioned into eternal rest. She is survived by her son Courtney Penn, daughter Yvette, sister Paulette, brother Alvin, four grandchildren, Justin, Shauna, D'Angelo, and Giovanni, three grandchildren, Kiara, Morgan, and Snyder, and adopted great son, Liam, nieces, nephews, other relatives, and friends. To have lost Miss Erna is heartbreaking. It has come as such a shock to us all. For we can, Lord, thy purpose see, but all is well that is done by thee. May her soul rest in peace, and life perpetual shine upon her. Goodbye, Miss Erna. You will live in our heart forever. Thank you.
I'd like us to recognize Mr. Coley, the chairman of RADA, is here with us. Could you just stand and recognize? Yes, Mr. Coley. At this time, we'll have a tribute in song and floral tribute by Barrington Morris' cousin, children, and grandchildren.
Good afternoon, everyone. But as you can see, I'm not Mr. Barrington's hearing. I'll be just trying to warn you. When you're weary, feeling small, and tears are real, your eyes, I will try them all. I'm on your side.
all the family members to stand while we have prayer and comfort for the family by Reverend Sasha Lambert. Family members, could you stand, please?
While the family members are standing, we just want to again extend condolences to all of you on behalf of your family at Zorn Memorial Moravian Church, that we just continue to hold you up in our prayers, Sister Yvette, and all the family members, as we know that you will definitely grieve individually and collectively, but we know that indeed God knows the depth of your grief, and he will indeed give you the assurance that each of you deserves. As I pray for them, I pray that you will pray with me as we continue to lift up the family in prayer at this time. Let us go to God in prayer. And for the family members that are close to each other, I'm just going to ask you to hold the hand of the family member next to you as a symbol of each of you holding each other up as you go through this time. Let us go to God in prayer. Many things about tomorrow we will never understand, but we know who holds the future, and we know he holds our hands. Lord, at this time, we will never understand the grief of this family. Lord, we can only sympathize and we can empathize. Lord, at this time, we are putting them in your capable hands. Because God, we know you are the God of comfort. We know, Almighty God, when we can't understand the sorrows that surround us, you will always send a word in time. Father, we pray right now, God, that you will be the hedge around them. Lord God, remind them even now that you are a present help in times of trouble. Father, we pray right now, God, that they remember the legacies. They remember the memories. God, they remember the special times with Sister Erna. That God, they will take these times even now and build on them for their own lives. God, you remind us even now that you will continue to surround and comfort. That God, you will give a peace that surpasses all understanding. Father, at this time, we stand in the gap for them. And we know, Almighty God, that your loving arms will surround them and will undergird them. Father, we pray right now, Almighty God, that no weapon formed against them shall prosper. Lord, we are thanking you right now, O God, that you will give a peace that surpasses all understanding. That mighty God, that peace you gave, no man can destroy. That peace you gave, no enemy can take away. That peace you gave, God, will give them a peace, God, that even themselves, they can't understand. We can't fathom, God, but that is all right, for it's a peace that comes from you. And so, God, we ask you even now, you are the joy giver. You are the joy giver. Lord, they will go through. And we know as they go through, God, you will hold their hands. Father, we thank you, Almighty God, that as we continue to just uphold them in prayer, that they will, mighty God, will bound with cords that cannot be broken. Father, we pray that now you release your love, your unconditional love over them. Father, they need you at this time. And we know, God, that you have already showed up and you will continue to show up. So God, be with them. Surround them. Cover them. Hover over them. Remind them you're in the midst to bless. And remind them, Almighty God, that you are not afar off. Your hand is not too short. And God, there is nothing too hard for you to do. So shelter them right now, God, under the shadow of your wings, for there is healing in your wings. And right now, God, we pray that they will look to you, the author and finisher of their faith. And for those, Almighty God, who have not yet said yes to you in this family, we pray you will speak to their hearts. Let them get right with you, even now, Almighty God. For tomorrow is promised to no one. And as tomorrow is promised to no one, and we only have today, let today, Almighty God, when they hear you knocking at their heart's door, that Father, they will even now let you in and have you come and sup with them. Lord, be with them. And as we continue to pray for them, we lift them up to your throne of grace. For only your grace is sufficient, as your mercies are new every single morning. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen and amen. Be comforted, family.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Reverend Amber, for that touching prayer. As we sing the final hymn and proceed to the family club, after we sing the first stanza of the chorus, the platform party will leave, followed by the casket and the pallbearers, and then immediately after that you'll have the immediate family, and we will leave the church in that manner. Let us stand as we sing the hymn. Will your arm propose?
What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. And what a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. What a peace we often forfeit. Needless pain we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful, who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Precious memories, unseen angels sent from somewhere to my soul. How they linger ever near me, and the sacred past unfold. Precious memories, how they linger stillness of the midnight. Precious sacred scenes unfold. Precious Father and loving Mother, fly across the lonely years, and old home scenes of my childhood in fond memory appear. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold. Mother praying, Father too, on bended knee. The sun is sinking, shadows falling, but their prayers still follow me. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the
yonder, I'll be there. And the bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share, when his chosen one will gather to their home beyond the sky, and the roll is called of yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll,
yes, on water,
yonder, when the rose is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Let us labor for the master from the dawn to setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all our life is over and our work on earth is done, and the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, yonder, when the road is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Fully.
Oh, when the road is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
My story,
Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long.
Perfect submission.
Perfect submission.
Visions of rapture now burst on my side. Angels descending, bring from above.
Angels descending, bring from above. Angels of mercy, whisper.
Let me hear you. This is my story.
This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior.
Perfect submission, filled with His goodness, lost in His love. I know we can do better than that, man. This is my story.
This is my story. This is my song.
Praising my Savior.
Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story.
Next song, the final one, Face to Face.
Face to face with Christ my Savior. Face to face, what will it be? When with rapture I behold Christ who died for me. Face to face shall I behold Him, far beyond the starry sky. Face to face in all His glory, I shall see Him by and by. But a blessed day is coming when His glory shall be seen. Face to face shall I behold Him, far beyond the starry sky.
When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Meet me by the river, Just one more while they finish up. One of your choice.
Oh, if you miss me, don't come searching. If you don't find me, then you know that I'm gone. And if you don't hear from me, don't come knocking at my door. I'll be gone in the twinkling of an eye.
Oh, if you miss me.
Oh, if you miss me, don't come searching. And if you don't find me, know that I'm gone. If you don't hear from me, don't come knocking at my door. I'll be gone in the twinkling of an eye.
Oh, if you miss me.
Don't come searching, and if you don't find me, then you know that I'm gone. If you don't hear from me, don't come knocking at my door. I'll be gone in the twinkling
of an eye. Just one more time.
Oh, if you miss me, don't come searching, and if you don't find me, then know that I'm gone. And if you don't hear from me, don't come knocking at my door. I'll be gone in the twinkling of an eye.
Dear Lord Jesus, we have done all that. The rest remain in your sovereign hand. Watch over this holy place until the trumpet of the Lord is sounded and the dead in Christ will rise, when we shall meet each other again. Bless his family and friends as they await the triumphant day when we shall meet each other again in glory. Send us home with loving care in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, Lord, give it to you.
The Lord take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen.
Amen. You can take your rest. On
this.
I remember Mama and the love that she gave. Leaning by her bedside, I can still hear Mama say, the people are depending on you, Shirley. Don't you let them down. I remember Mama in a happy way. We went to school with holes in our shoes. We didn't have much, but the Lord saw us through. Mama kept the family together. Yes, we did.
Mama, you gave life to me, turned a baby into a grown man. And Mama, all you had to offer was a promise of a lifetime of love. Now I know there is no other love like a mother's love for her child. And I know a love so complete someday must leave, must say goodbye.
When you need me, I'll be there for you all.